Sir, the Honorable Finance Minister is here. I would like to bring to the notice of the Honorable Finance Minister three issues which are very important in Finance Act, sir. First is cash withdrawal tax. Sir, the cash withdrawal tax which was introduced by the then Honorable Finance Minister Mr. Chidambaram was a deterrent, and then it was proved to be deterrent, and then subsequently it has been withdrawn. Now the Honorable Finance Minister is now reintroducing it in a different form. Sir, the cash withdrawals from the bank, after all, what is lying, the cash what is lying in the bank, the bank balance what is credited to the bank account is our own money which has been deposited in the bank. Sir, I really don't understand why the Honorable Finance Minister would like to tax the withdrawals from the bank. Sir, because it is neither a revenue nor an expenditure. When it is neither a revenue nor an expenditure, how the cash withdrawals can be taxed and brought within the purview of the Finance Act is the number one point, sir. Sir, the point number two is the filing of return. Sir, under 132 of the Income Tax Act, see, the original return can be filed, has to be filed on or before the stipulated period of time. Sir, if original return is not filed, see, there are some instances where the filing of return is mandatory even though there is no taxable income. When there is no taxable income, because of the mandatory nature of the mandatory obligation that is cast on the assessee to file the return, it eventually may not result in the paying of tax. So when there is no tax, the penalty, levying penalty, that too automatic penalty for not filing of return is not acceptable, sir. And when original return is not filed, and subsequently, in the earlier act, now before this amendment is brought into force, if somebody wants to file a revised return, to the best of my knowledge earlier, it can be filed within 1 year from the end of the assessment year. That was the original act, sir. When that was the act, and I really don't understand, because if at all some income has escaped assessment, the assessing officer can always issue a notice under section 148, and then thereafter the original return can be filed in response to the notice under 148, and subsequently within 1 year from the date of original return, a revised return can also be filed. Now that the Honorable Finance Minister has brought some amendment in that which is detrimental to the interest of the assessee, sir. And as I have told you, automatic penalty is also not acceptable. And coming to some plus points, sir, particularly for startup companies, see, the originally they were given exemptions from the angel tax, and now it has been extended to startups submitting the prescribed form. This is a welcome step, sir. Sir, coming to section 45ID, empowers the RBI over the NBFCs, and even it empowers even the RBI to remove certain directors, sir, in the interest of the public and in the interest of the debtor, in the interest of the depositors and creditors. This is again a welcome step, and under section 45ID, even the RBI can appoint a new administrator also. This is a welcome step. This is needed so that NBFCs do not run into massive losses, and which we have seen in the past. Sir, coming to the National Housing Bank, is a both refinancier and regulator of housing finance companies. This gives a somewhat conflicting and difficult mandate to NHB, National Housing Bank. It is a wise decision to return the regulatory authority over the housing finance company sector from the National Housing Board to the RBI, sir. Then coming to another point, sir, individuals earning more than 5 crore a year, income a year would now pay an effective tax of 42.7%, and those earning between 2 crores and 5 crores bringing their effective tax rate about 39%, sir. This is a good step, and as the idea of taxation is redistribution of wealth, sir. Sir, I would like to make some more suggestions to the Honorable Finance Minister. Sir, particularly the cess on petrol and diesel, which will adversely hit the farmers' interest most, sir. So we want the farmers to have money in their hands. If the diesel which goes into their tractors or farm equipment and they are taxed higher, the farmers have to spend much more, and which will adversely affect the interest of the farmers, sir. Sir, the 25% tax rate which will apply to the companies with an annual revenue of 250 crores, which will benefit, as per the statistics given by the Honorable Finance Minister, would be 99.3% of 1.5 million companies. My point is, why not 100%? Sir, this is another thing, sir. Sir, the 10% customs duty on newsprint, which will hit the small and medium news vendors already facing huge stress on its finances because of the increased cost and depleting the advertisement revenues, the customs duty will break their back, sir. And sir, the finance bill should further try to broaden the tax base. According to me, on perusal of records, what I could observe, the gross tax to GDP ratio declined from 10.9% to 11.2% last year, sir, because of the indirect taxes falling short of the budget estimates by about 16%. India's growth of tax revenues is not in sync with the GDP, sir. So these are all the suggestions what I could make, and I hope Honorable Finance Minister particularly take care of this cash withdrawal tax, which is not advisable, and it has been introduced and withdrawn, and again they are reintroducing it, and the filing of the automatic penalty in the case of original return, non-filing of original return, and the for the time for filing of revised return. Thank you very much.
Thank you.